Today we're going to upgrade an HP Pavilion model TP01-1016 by adding an M.2 NVMe SSD while also removing the original hard drive. Afterwards, we'll restore Windows to the newly installed NVMe. Unlike my other videos on the subject of cloning, I'll be performing a factory restore after I install the SSD. The HP Pavilion comes with a Seagate 1TB hard drive that has Windows 10 Home installed on it. Though it runs at 7200 RPM, I'll be adding a much, much faster NVMe module, but at the same time, I'll remove the 1TB hard drive as I don't plan to use it. This brings up the question of how do we transfer Windows to a brand new empty SSD if HP hasn't provided any installation media? The solution is to use built-in recovery tools in order to create recovery media on an intermediary USB flash drive while the original hard drive is in the computer, and then install Windows to the SSD using the flash drive after we remove the hard drive. You could always perform a clean install of Windows 10 using an image from Microsoft, and there are plenty of tutorials out there to guide you. But in this video, we're not just installing a base version of Windows 10. You'll also get all the drivers that you need as well. Unfortunately, that also means that you get all the bundled software that HP provides as part of the factory image, which may or may not be useful to you. For the purposes of this tutorial, the SSD I'll be installing is this Kingston 250GB 2280 NVMe module, and the USB flash drive is this Western Digital 64GB thumb drive. Please note that you don't need one this large. A 16GB thumb drive is sufficient. I'll also be using an ESD strap to prevent any static damage, and a screwdriver with a T15 Torx bit. If you don't have a Torx, you can use a flathead to open the case, and later when we install the SSD, you'll also need a Phillips head bit. Here, I've just booted from my brand new HP Pavilion, so I'm still booting from the hard drive. Before we begin, I just want to show you the partition configuration. Let's right-click the Start button and launch the Disk Management Utility. The hard drive, labeled Disk 0, consists of three sections: the EFI, a Windows partition, and a recovery partition. After we transfer everything over to the SSD, we should see the same three partitions. Let's first create the recovery media by inserting the empty flash drive into a USB port. Afterwards, search for the phrase "Create a recovery drive" and launch the returned result. Make sure the checkbox for Backup System Files remains checked and hit the Next button. The detection of the USB drive may take a minute, so let me fast forward a bit. Once it finds the flash drive, verify that it's correct and click Next. You'll get a warning alerting you that everything on the flash drive will be erased, so if you do have any critical data on it, now is the time to cancel the wizard and back up your files. Otherwise, click Continue. As it creates the recovery media, you may see File Explorer pop up, showing you the newly formatted drive and folders. Let's ignore this and go back to the wizard. Since this is going to take a while, I'll put some chicken nuggets in the toaster oven and I'll be right back. Okay, we're back. At this point, we can remove the USB drive from the computer and shut down Windows so we can get ready to install the NVMe and remove the hard drive. In a previously published video, I showed you how to dismantle the case to see all of the components that can be upgraded in this HP Pavilion model. In this video, I'll focus only on the steps necessary to install the NVMe and remove the hard drive. If you'd like, you can visit the other video from the link I've placed in the upper right-hand corner, as well as the description. The case has just one screw to unfasten, which is in the back of the unit. The screw itself is a Torx flathead hybrid, so you can use either bit for your screwdriver. We can then remove the side panel. When we look inside the case at a slightly higher angle, we'll need to remove this same size screw in order to remove this black cage. Let's also remove the SATA power and data connectors to the DVD drive, after which we can press the green lever to pull out the drive from the front. While we're at it, let's remove the SATA power and data cables for the hard drive, which is mounted at the front of the case. Next, I'll flip the case around and pull up on these three tabs, which releases the front face. Using the same screwdriver bit, we'll need to unfasten this screw, which allows us to take out the silver tray. But first you'll need to bend a flexible bracket on the tray's side to free up a spare SATA connector, after which you can angle it to about 45 degrees and lift up. While we're at the front of the computer, let's pan down. There are four screws holding the hard drive to the case. While you're working on the last one, make sure to hold the hard drive in place with your other hand, because it'll fall if you don't. We can then set the hard drive aside. Let's now switch to an overhead view, where I'll start by putting on my ESD strap and clipping the other end to the metal part of the case. The M.2 slot is here, and the screw mount for the 2280 module is here. Let's take our NVMe SSD, line up the notch on the stick with the notch on the slot, and gently push the module in at a slight angle. Leaving it at that angle, let's retrieve the screw from a small packet of screws that came with the computer. This is where a magnetic screwdriver comes in handy, since I can just allow the Phillips head bit to hold on to the screw. Afterwards, I'll push down on the NVMe module and align the holes such that I can dive in with the screwdriver and secure it in place. To reassemble the computer, we just go in reverse order, leaving out the hard drive. We'll start by affixing the silver tray, fastening it, replacing the front face, snapping the three tabs, inserting the DVD drive, securing the spare SATA connector to the bracket, reattaching the SATA power and data cables to the DVD drive, angling the black cage back in place, fastening the screw, flipping the case around, sliding the side panel back on, and finally, securing the last screw. Now, let's reinsert our USB flash drive and turn on the computer. The first thing you'll see is the HP logo, after which it'll boot immediately to the USB drive and ask you for your keyboard layout. You'll then want to choose the Recover option and then fully clean the drive, since you're restoring the factory image. It'll then warn you that the entire storage device will be wiped clean. And since this is a brand new NVMe SSD, I'll continue and hit the Recover button. From this point forward, it'll take about 30 minutes to fully restore the image, but I'll just go over some of the highlights. The screen will stay on this recovery mode for about 15 minutes, after which it'll start the installation phase. It'll restart the computer during this time, but after about 8 minutes, you'll see the normal setup screens for entering Windows. I myself haven't connected to the internet yet, so I'll be presented with a limited setup wizard, but whether you're connected or not, once you've completed the setup, you can log into Windows. When opening Disk Management, you'll now see the 250GB NVMe SSD labeled as Disk 0, with the same three partitions we saw earlier on the hard drive, albeit with a smaller Windows partition due to the smaller size of the SSD. Disk 1 is simply the USB flash drive that's still inserted in the USB port. You can either keep the flash drive in a safe place for future Windows recoveries, or you can simply recreate the recovery media on this SSD at a future time. Of course, it's better to be safe than sorry, so I recommend keeping the recovery on the flash drive if possible. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.